Blub blub everyone, welcome to the vast emptiness of space and our little corner in it. Apparently space is empty, although we know now that there is sentient life. Just don't know how to call them yet, but there is sentient life apparently. Let's see how far that goes. Let's see how far we are with that. Still 0% breakthrough chance. Hopefully they have the same breakthrough chance. Oh, they appear to be hostile? Huh, that is interesting. If that is the race I know, they shouldn't be hostile, but okay, they apparently are hostile. Interesting. Difficulty is still hell. So they could kill our scientist there. Let's hope they won't. Junkyard. This asteroid was evidently used as a junkyard by someone at some point in the distant past. All manner of discarded machinery and metallic refuse has been deposited inside the asteroid's weak gravity, well, being slowly pulled into the jumble of debris that now covers the surface. There's nothing of particular value to be found here, but a lot of the metal could be salvaged by a mining station. Gravity well of an asteroid? That can't be anything, right? I mean, Mars is a little bit smaller than Earth is, so why would there be gravity? There is no... Well, no, it doesn't have much gravity, right? One third, I think one third of Earth's gravity. So how much gravity could an asteroid have? Probably nothing. But oh well. Game says it does, so it does. It's so much cheaper, that's so great. Unfortunately, Industrial District still takes a while. And we have pops that are unemployed. That's bad. We want... There's a ruined ecology in here. Yeah, we need to rip them apart. We need to take this. We need the knowledge. Let's build a holo theater here, and let's build a holo theater here too. Because I think that is now important. These industries cannot... This planet can only support two buildings. Oh, they can have two now. That is new to me. As I played last, it could have only one of those. So can I still build one of this? Or maybe I'm not correct. Maybe it was... I could always build one of each. But I can't spam these anymore. Okay, interesting. Not sure what I will build there. Probably, this will probably be our, the planet to support our realm. Star and the other one will charted. Be the important planet Star that will support charted. Our military. Because it can be way bigger. Construction and I like complete. That. And there's another continental world and I love it. Please take this for me ASAP. I need this. No one has taken this yet. And we need continental worlds. Should we go there or there? This is a nice choke point and I don't know what this was. So I probably want to keep this. Oh my god, that's amazing trade. That is amazing trade. Still, we want this choke point at least.
Star system charted.
That is an important one. Found. Very hard, still too big. Unknown signal, weak, but insistent signal transmit on repeat in the Eptraburn system. The TSS Hubble has pinpointed its source to emanating from within the mouth of a destabilized subspace rift at the system's edge. What could be on the other side? Perhaps we shall find out. Yeah, hopefully. Maybe. I hope it's good. Please don't kill us. Finding the enemy now would murder us. That would not be ideal. We need to prepare. We need to find out. Okay, that is interesting. That means that probably this system has no connections to it whatsoever. And this wormhole will connect there. That's a special system and interesting. Of course, our people don't know that. Seismic disturbances. There have been many reports of unexplainable seismic disturbances. On Jolderun Prime, tremors can be felt across the planet and many of our settlements have suffered damage. While investigating the earthquakes, our scientists discovered a vast network of subterranean caverns. Okay. The deepest of these caverns are home to some kind of indigenous civilization, and they appear to be tunneling towards the surface. Ground vibrations from our settlements may have triggered this behavior, but we cannot be certain. There's no telling how these aliens will react when they spill out from their tunnels and encounter a colonist. We have to deal with the situation. We can establish communications, or we can do a preemptive strike. To be honest, I never did the preemptive strike. We know the enemy came from space. From the far corners of our galaxy, or what we knew about it. And it did strike hard, and surprisingly. So this cannot be the enemy. So I think it is more important to find out what it is and what they know, or what we can learn from it, than to strike it down. Situation log updated. I think we should establish communications. Oh, that is a lot. That is a lot of society research. My goodness, okay. Let's hope that's a good idea. Although I have to try and then strike him one time. Oh, there are the Zeta aliens. So, what are you? Huh. Are you just flying through? It could be a science vessel. I'm actually not sure what it is. It isn't flying to the stars, so it won't be a construction vessel. That means we can take advantage of this. And I think I will. Because we will take this one to have a clear border with whatever comes from there. Our attempts to covertly delve into the network systems of the Zeta aliens to find out more about them have been unsuccessful. Envoy Daisy Jacobs and her science team quickly realized that the system they were up against was simply too advanced. The systems were too advanced. The Overseer's too vigilant to be caught out in this manner. Fortunately, she was able to abort the hacking attempt before it was detected. That is lucky for us. Because if they're already hostile, that's not good. We will have to do this the hard way then. Which is very bad. Okay, let's hope we're quick enough. We're quicker than they are, because I need the influence you can gain from that. We are actually not expanding hard enough at the moment. So I'm thinking about building another one. Which will probably be the last. And we should build up a fleet now. There is an imminent threat there. We need to be prepared. It won't be a great fleet, but it will be something. Something to protect us. And we need, as our Empress said, we need to be the wall that stops everyone that tries to harm us. Okay, we need more housing here. So it's probably wise to save up for that. Complete. And we need more food. Encounter in Blondie, Kappa aliens. Oh god. What the heck are you again? I know what they are. Yeah, they're pirates. Look at that. Ships with asteroids in them for whatever reason. Well, they are two asteroids built together into a ship. Which is actually pretty dumb, because this material is way too dense and unnecessary dense, which will make it almost impossible to maneuver. But yeah. That's pirates for you. So that's what's in there. Okay. Don't know how we know at the moment, but okay. Diego, you have to investigate. They're hostile, so better not be killed. Although I don't care about you, because you cannot get any. Wait, that is strange. Why? Yeah, that is a science ship. Okay. But why can't you... Oh, because we don't have enough alloys. Okay, next month.
Star system charted.
I want this system. Not because it's a good system, but because I want to have a strict border. And if they are here with science ships, that means they will be there with a with the constructors soon. After that, you go here. Although even more because this system is completely worthless, apparently. Oh no, not completely. Don't know why I can't see this. Probably after you leave, I can. Strange aliens all over.
Star system.
Oh, I know. No, it's not pirates. It's worse. It's worse than pirates. I know what that is. That's marauders. We have one, two, three. One up to three in the galaxy, so... Being next to them is probably not ideal, although it will keep this corner of the galaxy away from us. Unfortunately, us from the galaxy, from the this corner of the galaxy too. Although we can, yeah, we can go through here, it's fine. It is boxing us in a way. Suddenly I don't need you that much. Sad. Just go here. We need to go there, and you will build these stations. Okay. Let's see what's happening. This is very important for us. And it'll take, oh my god, so long. So long. We are 14 years after day zero. Well, after... Yeah, after the emergence into space. We have the trade in here, but the thing is... Yeah, there are pirates coming. We can't do much about that until we can upgrade. So we probably just have to deal with the pirates. Cannot afford to reinforce, okay.
Star system charge.
Is there a good leader available for a fleet? Good admiral. Leader upkeep cost? No, it's just crap. So let's just wait. Don't want any of these. These wormholes will be interesting. And they're not in our heart. In our heart territory. So that is good for us. Definitely something I like. And this seems like it would connect in here and then in here, I guess. We are exploring. Exploration has gotten slower. I never built the next science ship, right? Never did. So let's do that after the corvettes. Still just a few, and our power is just laughable. Absolutely laughable. I am very interested in these guys.
Construction complete.
Okay, that is good for us. Yeah, let's just go here because I want this. They are not allowed to take this, and I don't know where they come from. Another faction. Sacrosanct Truths. Wait, what? How? How can we get spiritualists? Empire has an active non-governing faction. Yeah, that's all. Why did they come up? There shouldn't be any spiritualists in this empire. Finding spiritualist beliefs to be a minority issue in Terran Empire will displease the committee. It is a minority. And it's very expensive to sacrifice anything to suppress the faction. But I would like to. I would like to do so. Pious minds think alike and have at least 25% of the population be some form of spiritualist will please the committee. Yeah, that won't happen. Having spiritualist values be reflected in your empire governing ethics will please... No. No, 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 no. Empty shells allowing the placement of organic life with robotic workers will displease you. Yeah, you will be displeased. And I would like to get rid of all of you. I would like to suppress you to hell. But that's a problem. That was probably just normal drift. Oh, we have some technology here to be gained. You go there, that's fine. But you will do this. And you will go here and do this afterwards. Just to keep everything in order. We have to watch our food. I say as it flips over and just ruins everything. I think this one will also be for food. Just some food. It's actually a mineral planet. I don't want to waste anything on food in here, though. And our main planet is pretty small. Well, planet size 22 is actually not that bad. So we may be able to get by getting another food. There's a lot of ruined stuff in here, and we should investigate. Did I build everything in here that I wanted? Kind of, but we are missing housing in here, so we should build a city district. We will get to the old tech and old knowledge soon. Oh, this is risky. Okay, it's just they are just doing science in here. That's fine because we can already take this. Mummified pilot. Mummified remains of a single individual belonging to a previously unknown mammalian species. So more aliens. Great. Have been found drifting in high orbit over ZPA-3A. The being is dressed in what appears to be a flight suit complete with a helmet and maybe a fighter pilot that ejected in some ancient battle, only to be forgotten and left behind. Our study of the corpse has provided some interesting data. So, our Empress grows more and more concerned since we are finding all the evidence of other life forms, which we didn't find. Sentient life forms, too. Which we didn't find in our universe before. So, what happened? And they are very old, apparently, since these were mummified. What is this? Alpine. Alpine I don't really care for. What really happened here? We probably want these three systems too. Don't know why it doesn't show me these. Maybe because I'm in there. Just wait for them to leave. Signs of barbarism. Although their dwellings on habitat stations would suggest an advanced society, Envoy Diego Mendez is unsure whether we are indeed dealing with an intelligent life form. They seem unremittingly hostile, so much so that a stable society seems almost unthinkable. Even during our brief period of investigation, we have observed several displays of pure barbarism. They seem to have a language, but our linguists are still working on deciphering it, so we can make sense of this display. Disturbing, you must be watchful. Yes, it's very disturbing. They aren't nice people, so... yeah, nothing new there. Okay, we could increase our fleet size a little bit more. Probably be worth it.
Anomaly found.
There's a new science ship. Let's get another scientist. They are all bad. Let's take the youngest then. It's fine. Should you go wherever? There is one here already. where should we go? Probably up here. You are going to go there. So you... Wait, no, we want you. You up here, okay. We want you to come here and excavate this site before you find a tragic end or something. So you are going to do these, which means you can go up here and do that. Okay. There are a lot of people becoming supporters of this. I don't like, even on Terra. Okay, this cannot stand. I'm gonna suppress this faction. I don't care about the influence. Just get rid of it.
Special
and
project
now completed. It will be, it will be hard, but it's fine. Special project completed. One of our probes burrowed through the ground and intercepted the tunneling aliens on Jolteron Prime. After the startled alien workers calmed down, the probe was successful in establishing communications with the leaders. Open the channel. Subterranean aliens, is this thing on? Can you see us, surfaces? We understand you hail from the great nothing that lies upwards, beyond the stone. It was assumed nothing living could exist there. Well, that is quite true. But evidently, this is not so. What are your intentions? Tell us about yourselves. Our empire stretches across every pocket of the known world. Only the great nothing lies beyond our reach. We have many fine cities, supported by lichen farms and the fish we catch in the large rivers flowing through our tunnels. This has been our way for thousands of years. Our diggers heard the faint echoes of your cities through the stone, and we decided to investigate. We could force them to submit or be destroyed, or we could coexist in peace, which increases our research or society research from jobs. This is on Joldarun Prime. Maybe. It's not supposed to be a science world, though. Add subterranean contact zone to Joldarun Prime with the following result. More generator, more districts in general. Okay. Subterranean liaison officer jobs and subterranean liaison officer jobs per 20 pops. Okay. Well, let's do that. A liaison officer should be interesting. Would like to coexist. Then so we shall, officer. Let us share this world together in the spirit of peace. We would be most... I never killed them, by the way. I may have to one day. We would be most interested in trading with your people. I believe we have much to offer one another. We shall return to our cities and make the arrangements. That is a great deal, I hope. Let's now see what this job does. It's not filled, apparently. There it is. Subterranean liaison officer. More amenities? Okay. Trade value? That's great, actually. So that means energy. Pure energy. And pop housing usage minus one. Well, that is okay. It's just normal pop. Great. That is a good deal, actually. I never looked at that, to be honest. What it actually does. Would you please build a outpost in here for us? Great. Now they can't. Well, they can try, but they will fail. Basic strikecraft. Yes, please. We need fighters. We don't have anything at the moment, and we need more presence in the great void, for us to, well, to prevail, actually, to just live, to exist, to defend ourselves, and we have to do this. It's of the utmost importance to our Empress. How do you like the narrative so far? I find it shapes up greatly at the moment. I didn't even think about the galaxy, how it differs from the normal Battletech galaxy, which is amazing. Oh yeah, galactic ambition, please. So that saves us a bit. And we get our first ascension perk. To be honest, there's a lot that would be nice here. Like, more envoys are always nice. Not at this moment, but in general. That is not important to me, actually. Edict capacity could be interesting. We didn't even look at edicts yet. Administrative capacity is always good. Mastery of Nature, great perk. If you have, it's also for later, but if you have an Ascension perk left and don't know what to do with it, this is a great thing to do. Blockers don't matter, but paying some influence, which you will have a lot of in the late game, to increase your district capacity by 2 on every single planet can be amazing. So this is a good perk. One Vision, absolutely amazing. More unity, pop amenity usage goes down, although that's not a problem for us. Governing ethics attraction goes up, great. I love technological ascendancy, though. More chances to find rare technologies, a better chance, rather. Better research speed in general, 10% forever, great. I love technology. And we are a very technological species, so this will improve us greatly and help us for a long time. Unfortunately, in the late game, this is a dead perk. But it helps us to be in a better position in the late game. So that is why I take this. I also like Interstellar Dominion. The quicker you can get this, the better. Just because you can just expand faster, which is great. Although you have to balance your Empire Sprawl. Nihilistic Acquisition, never took this one. I don't care about raiding. Although you can get more pops, which is nice, but I don't care. I probably will take those two. And for a third one, I don't know. Maybe Shared Destiny, because that can be interesting later. But we will see. Let's just take the Technological Ascendancy now, because I want to get ahead in research. We want to be prepared. We need technology to survive. And the enemy had a lot of technology. And we cannot fall behind on that. We will not fall behind. Sorry, I had to drink something.
Construction complete.
Okay, perfect. That means another planet. That is actually a lot of planets. In my last few playthroughs, some of them being co-op, that was a big problem. I would even suggest that they change the algorithm that generates the galaxy, and less worlds are being generated now. Because we are at one times world generation, so it's very interesting. Maybe we are just lucky that we find a lot of continental worlds at the moment, which is great. It will help us a lot. I think station output, although I like the laser, more research station output will be great. We need more research.
Anomaly found.
We are falling somewhat behind. Let's take a gun battery. Doesn't change the guns, by the way, on the station, so it doesn't matter which one you take. The gun battery, the rockets, it really is of no consequence, as far as I know. We need the growth speed, but I want food because we are at problems with that. Food is a problem. Okay. Although that should change in a second? No, it didn't. Oh, okay. That is bad. We need housing. Yeah, there is a city district. We will need housing here very soon. So we probably want to build another city district. What's happening? A collective intelligence. Ah, okay, that's why. Yeah, okay, I was thinking that must have been the case. And I read this today, actually, that it's harder. With hive minds. Our efforts to decipher the signals picked up from the Zeta aliens have paid off, and we are finally able to open diplomatic channels with the civilization we know now to be the Vivisandia entity. Remarkably, they appear to completely lack the concept of individuality that is inherent in the Terran species. Indeed, the individual Vivisandian drone has no free will or thought whatsoever and is a mere pawn of the hive mind. Far from what chafing under such tight control, our researchers speculate that the Vivisandia have evolved to depend on this collective intelligence and would not be able to survive without it. We should study them and apply the learnings on our own workers. Oh, that's interesting. Hive mind drone study modifiers added for 180 months. I didn't even know that would be possible. Giving the following effects: worker pop resource output goes up. But only for 180 months? That's not much. I mean, what is that? That's 15 years? I think it's 15 years. It's 120 is 10 years, and another 80 months? No, 60 months? Yeah, it's 5 years. It's 15 years, okay. But 15 years worker pop resource output is great. Ends the first contact procedure. We will find future first contact process easier to complete. That's good. And we get intel. What is this? A fascinating species. We must find out how such a phenomenon is possible. That's just some research. It's actually not that much research. But it's better No, it's the same influence. So yes, I want the resource. The pop resources. Till 2230, 10% more resource output is great.
A foreign power is hailing us.
We are the Vivisandia entity, and we speak as one. This is actually a entity I made up, or a species. Actually, I didn't change the room. That's sad. No, it did change the room. Why isn't it showing? I know I did. I did change the room. That is very strange. Huh. We speak as one. The hive mind has taken note of your presence. We will observe for now. Our future actions will depend upon whether you are a threat, an opportunity for expansion, or an unforeseen variable. We will have much to gain from this encounter. You will embrace the greater good eventually. Respect our authority or else. Does that change anything? Okay, their opinion goes towards friendly. The spy network growth goes down. Or the opinion goes down, but our spy network growth goes up. Okay. I actually would like to be on good terms with them. They are in a normal hive mind. There shouldn't be... Well, it's rather... Do I want to prevent them from gaining spy network on us? Or do I want the relations with them? They could be the great enemy. We don't know yet. So yeah, you will embrace the greater good eventually. Interesting. And I think they should be around here. Or maybe I don't see them at all. Probably at the end of the month, right? Oh, there's Vivius. Okay, that's bad. That means... Yeah, there's an outpost of theirs. There is two. This one I got. Okay, so we have... Actually, this would be the okay border there. And the planet would be helpless. It's not ideal. It's really not ideal. The Alpine world... I was thinking the Alpine world was theirs, but I was hoping they were here and not down here. Vivius is... Ah, there it is. There's the background I've chosen. Send the way of the Vivisandia entity. Whatever you wish to discuss, reconcile yourselves with the inevitable something of your something. Okay. I think we try to improve relations... I think we try that. Not Daisy. Someone else will do that. And we will have a spy network too. Yilin will spy. Which will be very hard because they are a hive mind. Yeah, which... but they have more encryption than we do. That, and then we have code breaking. That means the infiltration level goes down. So we can only go up to 30, which is not much. But still enough to prepare sleeper cells and acquire an asset. And acquiring an asset will help us to get more. So that would be interesting. However, we could acquire an asset, but, you know, taking them over somewhat. Okay, we are improving relations, which is fine. Minus 160. Spy network established. We have received our first clandestine report from Spymaster Yilin inside the Vivisandia entity. This heralds the foundation of our first spy network within the Xeno Empire. From this day forward, they too will realize the formative benefits of Terran-honed information control.
Construction complete.
And there they are. Okay, we don't know much about them. They expanded to the east, which is good for us. I made this empire, and I'm really enjoying it so far. I'm interested in how it goes. Okay, they're belligerent. Oh, they are really aggressive. For what reason, though? I mean, they are Gestalt consciousness, but... Their pop growth speed is down. Interesting that we can see all this. They have a lot of habitability. Yeah, I gave that to them, I think. Probably not the best idea in the world, but we will see. And we should protect our border now. We have two star bases here and here to build. But I think it would be the best thing to build a star base here. We will not be able to protect the planet much. But that's fine, I guess. Yeah, and they close the borders on us. Bad. Okay. So just build this here. We need more stuff. Still, we found the first sentient aliens. Unfortunately, they are hive mind that wants to murder us. Brutally. Great. Spiran freeholders encountered. Having decoded what counts as a language among them, Envoy Diego Mendez has identified the Kappa aliens as a nomadic civilization known as the Spiran freeholders. They occupy a number of large space stations in and around the Blonde system that house... that house the bulk of their massive numbers in crowded and squalid conditions. Despite this, or perhaps because of it, they seem to have developed a strong martial culture. Well, we have one too, so that's fine. We can deal. Life in the cold void has become second nature to them, and they are very adept at space warfare. There is no Spiran central government to speak of. Instead, they are divided into several different factions that vie endlessly with one another for resources and respect. Given their large population and the shipbuilding capability of their stations, this constant infighting is the only thing keeping them from growing into a significant threat to galactic peace. Attempt to contact them. At least we get a lot of influence. Outsiders! We are the Spiran. Unlike the civilized star nations of the galaxy, we have no single master to lord over us. But I have been chosen to convey this message to you on behalf of all the houses. Do not try to impose your soft and effete ways upon us. I don't know this word. You may freely send your alien ships into Spiran territory, but do not expect them to return. Our warriors will welcome the diversion, however. Transmit on this frequency only if you wish to offer tribute, or if you have need of mercenaries as well as the means to pay for them. Okay, Mr. Freeholder, thank you. Thanks for the information. So that is done too. Unfortunately, this part is already over again. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If so, please leave me a like and subscribe if you aren't subscribed, and we will see each other next time at Stellaris with the Terran Star Empire in somewhat, well, I don't want to say dire straits, but with a potential very big enemy to the east, which we do not know anything about. Our intel is pretty bad too, that's great. And another very openly hostile pirate faction, or somewhat like pirate faction, that could just explode and kill us all. Great. Good times. See you next time, everyone. Goodbye.